Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to CommandFest Online 2. Thank you for joining us for our second day of Commander. My name is Eric Levine, and I'm going to be your host for the first half of the day once again. CommandFest Online is a charity event, and we, this weekend, are supporting the NAACP Legal Defense and Educational Fund. That is America's premier legal organization fighting for racial justice through litigation, advocacy, and public education. It's a fantastic cause, and you can go ahead and check that out at channelfireball.com/donate. That is our charity campaign for the NAACP LDF. You can make donations there that will not only benefit that fantastic cause, it might also change the course of a game in progress. That's right. We've got four matches that we're going to stream to you today, along with two panels. And in those matches, if you donate and select a specific incentive, you can make something happen in the game. You can see all of those incentives on the screen here. Let me tell you a little bit about a couple of my favorites. For $200 in the first 45 minutes of a game, you can revive a player who was eliminated. So if your favorite player was unfairly targeted first, you can go ahead and revive them. Some of my other favorites include the $250 Wheel of Fortune effect, and of course, on the simpler side, the $50 Everybody Gets to Search for a Basic Land effect, because everybody likes to ramp a little bit. So go ahead and check those out, and don't forget, we may be adding some match-specific ones as we go along, so keep checking back on the Tiltify campaign. We'll have lots more there for you. Yesterday, we did manage to give Riley Knight 8 extra turns through some secret extra incentives, so keep an eye out for things like that. Let's talk a little bit about the schedule for today. Coming up in just a couple of minutes here, we've got our first match with AliasV, DeQuan Watson, Gavin Duggan, and Lee Livingston. Following that, we've got a panel with the Commander Rules Committee. So we're going to see Toby, Sheldon, Gavin, and Scott in action talking about the things they love in Commander and answering your questions. We've got match two coming up after that with Sheldon Menery, Scott Larrabee, Kristen Gregory, and Tomer Abramovici. Following that is a third match with mystery decks that I myself designed. So the Asian Avenger, Jeremy Knoll, Toby Elliott, and Ellie of the Veil have no idea what they're going to be playing. I don't even know which of the four decks that I sent out each of them got. So that's going to be a fun surprise. After that, we'll have a panel on how to introduce new players with Alex Kessler, and that's going to be a panel about getting new players into Commander, of course. And finally, closing out the broadcast today, we'll have match number four with Kyle Hill, Gavin Verhey, Amazonian, and David McDarby. If you'd like to join in the fun and play in CommandFest this weekend, you can do that right now. Just head on down to the Channel Fireball Discord and hop in a game. You can use our Discord bot, Spellbot, to help you set your power level, pick a team, and find a game with like-minded players. What's that about teams, you ask? Well, I have good news. CommandFest Online 2 is seeking to settle the score between cats and dogs, just like Core Set 2021 did. So when you go into Discord, you can set your team as Team Cats or Team Dogs and earn points for your team. At the end of the weekend, the winning team will get to keep their Discord and Twitch emotes for their team. And they're special emotes designed by Inkling Customs. They're very cool. I hope everybody's spamming them right now. I think that's about it for me. We're just about ready to go to the next game. So are we ready to head down to that game? Alrighty, it sounds like we're ready to head down to the game. James, our producer, has given me the go-ahead. So let's go to the game.
Oh, hi, everybody.
Hey.
All right. Hello, everybody. My name is Ailey, or AliasV, if you check me out on Strum. I am playing Morphon the Boundless in a dragon deck. So my game plan is try and kill everyone as quickly as I possibly can in fiery hellstorm, death, and destruction.
I guess I'll go next. I am DeQuan, otherwise known as Power Dragon. I stream on Twitch 3 days a week and put YouTube videos up every day and have a podcast called Color of Magic. And today I am playing Rith the Awakener. So I'm playing... This is really an excuse for me to play all the big giant creatures I never get to play with in 60 card magic. So I'm hoping just have a lot of fun today. No idea how it's going to do, but we're going to find out. And we're on Team Cats, by the way, with my little wavy cat here.
Yeah, kitty cats. I have two next to me right now grooming each other, so let's hope they don't inject themselves into this matchup.
Hey, I'm Lee Livingston. I occasionally write commander articles for CFB, and today I'm going to be making a whole bunch of thrall tokens with Endrek Sahr and looking to make as many deals as I possibly can.
Nice. Hey, everyone. I'm Gavin, otherwise known as the member of the rules committee that nobody knows exists. I run the website and the social media for the RC and basically helped set things up in this the early days. I'm online Twitter at Genomancer, and I'll be playing Rhys the Redeemed, whole in honor and horn, making some tokens and hopefully stopping Ailey from killing us all.
No, that's no fun.
Also on Team Cats. So I think, are we all Team Cats?
If we're all Team Cats, then this is wonderful.
As it should be.
Cats will score one today, one way or the other.
Yes. All right. How are we deciding who goes first? Shall we give it the old roll? Sweet.
Yeah, let's told. Okay, let me bust my secret out here.
Cats, do not steal my. Oh, that's cool. I like your dice thingy.
I got an 18.
Wow, I got 3.
Oh, you're leaving 2d6s. Hold on. I'm cheating. Here we go.
I don't know. I rolled 2d20, so.
I have an 8.
I've got a 4.
So, DeQuan still goes first?
I got a 12. Or I got an 11.
11. All right.
Okay. Then Gavin.
Which is really funny because I got a rolling gag on the Commander's Twitch stream that I always roll 11 on a d20. So, apparently it's stuck.
That's funny.
Heck yeah. Right.
Good luck. Have fun. Let's go.
All right. Rock and roll. I will open on a Rushlands and pass the turn.
All right.
Oh, are we going to do the space bar thing?
Yeah.
Can. Heck yeah. Look at that. I'll do Swamp, a Stitcher Supplier, then Razakath Swamp and a Plague Crafter, and I'm good.
Cool. I will draw my card as per the rules. And I will play...
I might get beat down by a Stitcher Supplier.
Sulfur
it will
falls.
Go the distance.
And just tap as I don't have a mountain.
All right. I will not do much myself, it doesn't look like. I think I'm just going to play a Carplusion Forest, and that is all.
All right.
There you go.
So I don't own a cat, but I do own a 7-year-old who might appear in the background. So he's unlikely to climb on the table like a cat. But he is likely to run into the room. Man, you know what I forgot to do on turn one? Play my commander. I'll play Rhys Smuggler's Copter and pass the turn.
We are not upset by this mistake.
It's totally fine.
Downside to the one cost commander. You'll forget to do that.
Yeah. Just brain fart.
Well, this will work as a good draw for second turn, I guess. I'll play a Soul Ring.
Well, you're the enemy.
Yep, someone has declared archenemy.
That was my intent from the start. Phyrexian Rager. Lose life, draw a card. I'm going to attack Gavin for one.
Yep, take it and like it.
Fantastic. Pass the turn.
Step. All right. Not a very exciting start here for good old dragons. Lift up retreat tapped, as I don't control a mountain or plains. Pass my turn.
All right. Let's draw. Just going to play a land and a moss diamond. And that is it.
Nice. So good.
Heck yeah.
All right. Plains, Rhys. crew bash Lee for three. I will draw and discard.
You know, that's fair. I will accept this.
Pass the turn.
All right. Let's go with... Let's just do Swamp and get the Thrall Father out now. Hey, Ailey, pick three.
Yeah. How much are you hitting me for?
Three.
Three?
Two, two, and a one, one.
I accept the charges.
Three, three, three.
Now, also, have the turn.
Oh, thank you. We'll gladly take it from you.
Nothing's
worth it. A little damage and then the turn. That's a fair way to do it.
See? If you accept this damage, I'll pass the turn. It'll all work that well.
Can we just hold it otherwise?
Yeah.
Wait, does this mean I can not pass the
negotiation?
I mean, turns can be hostily taken over, apparently. So.
Excellent.
That is true. I'm going to cast Dragon's Horde. Whenever a dragon enters under my control, I get a gold counter. I can remove a gold counter to draw a card. Add one mana of any color. Go. All
right.
And I am just going to play a Tangarth. So, for those of you who haven't seen it, he can't be blocked by more than one creature. And whenever I have him and he's tapped, when an opponent goes to attack, I can pass him over and decide who he is also attacking.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, pretty nifty.
Cheeky.
And that's it.
That's pretty good. That's great.
I'm a little upset that you're not playing dragons, if I'm honest.
I have a dragon.
Well, you have a dragon.
I don't have the mana yet.
Are you not dragon tribal?
No. Makes sense. It's just a bunch of really big creatures.
Okay. That's fair. That's on brand.
We will accept this.
I will make an elf token and gear up the copter and bash Endrek Sahr for three.
Love the thopter noise that arena makes.
It's
better than the Murloc noise in that other game.
Yeah.
Or whatever that is.
Oh, man. Huh.
What'd you draw? I'll help you.
You know the worst part about looting? It's not the drawing. All right. I'm going to discard Ren's Running Packmaster and pass the turn.
Sounds good.
Discarding a Packmaster. Okay.
All right, let's play Greed.
Ooh.
And I guess one good turn here is another. Ragers are going to come at you, Gavin.
All right. 37. Well, you didn't attack me with everything, so I think I probably won't attack you back. We'll see.
No, I'll make that deal. Go ahead, Ailey.
Thank you.
All right, Ailey, it's your turn to get a creature on the table.
Yeah, I'm getting there. Don't rush me. Dragons take time.
I want that as a bumper sticker. Dragons take time.
Dragons are worth the wait.
That's my parenting philosophy.
They might. The rest. And then I'm going to cast Ulagan the Storm's Fury. It's a flying 4/5. Whenever a dragon you control attacks, they get +1/+0 until end of turn. Counter here. And that is going to be my turn. No haste or anything, just hanging out.
I got knocked out of a GP by Colian. It was frustrating.
With the dash.
All right. Let's see what we got. Display a Windswept Teeth, and we'll play a Darksteel Ingot. I will attack probably Gavin with 5 from Tangarth.
5 is the number of the Minotaur. Drop to 32.
And I will pass.
All right. I will crew the copter and hit DeQuan for 3.
Sounds fair. Retaliatory strikes are welcome.
Pitch a Null Mage Shepherd and play Glare of Subdual. It is an enchantment that lets me tap a creature to tap an opponent's, to tap any artifact or creature. It is a, sort of a weird combination of Rattlesnake and Gorilla. Pass the turn.
All right, end of your turn. Let's draw 1 card off Greed. And then I'll draw another card off Greed. And then I'll draw for my turn. Do land for the turn. Let's play everyone's favorite Sahr robot. Endrek will get me 4 1-1s.
And I'm going to go ahead and go to 36 and just fetch on your turn.
Sounds good. Get a swamp.
Well, this guy's gross. I just read what your commander does. I'm like, wait a minute.
I can only have so many thralls, though.
How many?
If I play... a 3 CMC creature, that alone will make him go away.
Ah.
Getting a scrub land, by the way, okay. In case anybody's curious.
Huh. Icky.
Then I'll add a Phyrexian Reclamation to the board. And I'm going to go to combat. And I think I'm going to throw a Rager and a Supplier towards Gavin. Hey, hey, DeQuan, you want to throw Tongarth at him too?
I'm trying to decide which of you is more threatening. I might actually need Gavin to get past whatever this pile of thralls is about to be doing.
Yep.
I will actually defer to Ailey and let her decide. Does Tangarth join this attack or not?
Oh!
How big is Tangarth?
He is 5'5".
5'5"? No, I think Gavin's been beat up on quite a bit. Just let him have his 1-1s. It's fine.
Fair enough.
All right, well then 3's coming at you, Gavin.
3 and a 3.
See, now we're even.
Yeah. All is well.
Hey, and Mr. Baby Necropotence over there. Guess what?
I don't know what you're talking about. Pay no heed to my board. It's fine.
Well.
I promise I will do as much damage to myself as you all will.
All right, I am going to remove a gold counter and draw a card. Aha! I wasn't looking for land. No, not at all. Opulent Palace enters the battlefield as a Sultai land. I can tap for any of those colors. And then I'm going to cast Crucible of Fire.
That's big.
My dragon is now a big old 7-8 now.
Nice.
Which is fun. Who wants some love? DeQuan, it looks like you need some love.
I totally understand.
Yeah. So he's going to be a 8? 8-powered friend coming at you. Whadum.
Well, see, I'm going to do you a favor, because I heard you were looking for land, so I'm going to path to exile that guy.
It's you a gift. Wouldn't.
It's a gift.
I guess so. I'm guessing he goes into exile, yeah?
Yes.
Goodbye, my little friend. All right. I guess final land?
Basic land.
All right. I will pass my turn and cry about my exile dragon.
All right. Let's see what we can do here.
Rude.
It's not enough mana. That's all right. Hopefully we'll have enough mana soon. So we're going to play Mirari's Wake. And a Grove of the Burn Willows. And... The big creatures don't like sitting on defense, but I may have to. So Tangarsk and I just hang out, and we're going to pass the turn.
I have a Mirari's Wake. Don't worry, I'm not doing anything.
Sadly, if you could see my hand, the Mirari's Wake is not great right now.
I have all of this mana and nothing to spend it on.
Pretty much.
All right.
Judge my shuffling cat.
I'm going to play Int. No, that's a bad idea. Don't do that.
I would like you to do that. Bad ideas are great.
Yeah, that's true. That's true, but... All right, I'll play Growing Rites of Itlamok.
Ooh.
Nice.
It flips on 4 creatures at end step, right?
Yeah.
Come.
So we're not there yet. I'm going to look at the top 4 cards in my library, reveal a creature card. It is a Selesnya Guildmage. I'll put it in my hand. The rest go on the bottom. And I will pass the turn.
Let's do 4 life and 2 more cards.
Bill, this is about to get scary.
I've got...
If we don't punish him for that, then the card is free.
Fair.
Everybody, punish me for my hubris.
Good news. We have a couple of donations coming in. First off, we have a $50 donation for each player to draw a card.
Nice. Much appreciated.
So go ahead and enjoy that. And then there was a $200 donation from Anthony Alonji and Mary Janice Davidson Alonji, who said, this is a fabulous idea. Keep up the great work. They did not pick an incentive, so we might look into... We're going to do a Twitch poll to figure out what incentive we're going to use. So I'll let you know about that in just a few minutes.
That sounds spicy. Okay. Drew played land, drew card for them all being awesome.
Yes, they are awesome.
Let's play an Ashnod's Altar.
Ugh.
Okay.
All right, so I've got Ashnod's Altar. And I'm actually going to pass the turn.
Thank you.
That's highly suspicious.
Don't be suspicious. Don't be suspicious.
You know, likey.
Just don't do things that I don't likey, and you'll have plenty of likey.
Hey, Ailey, if you have a board sweeper, I wouldn't counter it if you chose to play it.
Okay, follow-up question. Could you counter it if she
did? I cannot. But it's still a true statement.
At no point did I lie in this.
Exactly. We're nothing but honest dragons in this part of the world.
All right, let's get it out of the way. This statement is a lie.
All of my deals are 100% truth.
No, no, not your statement. My statement. These all stink.
All righty, folks. So we've got information about the Twitch chat poll for that $200 donation. What we're going to do is we're going to put up a poll where you in chat can select any of the following options. Each player searches for a non-basic land. Everyone shuffles their graveyard into their library. Each player sacrifices a creature, or each player discards a card. And we'll take chat's two favorites. So go ahead and vote in that Twitch poll as soon as it comes up.
I'm gonna do my stuff before they vote on that, I guess.
Before they pick, I don't blame you.
20 seconds? Okay, I can do it. Right. 1, 2, 3.
Point of order. Do donation effects go on the stack?
Yes.
I believe that's how we treated it.
Okay, good.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm gonna say yes.
I'm gonna cost Swiftfoot Boots. Sure.
Being a judge.
Swiftfoot Boots. Gonna
cost Intet the Dreamer. I'm just using all my mana up while I can. Counter on that. I'm going to equip Swiftfoot Boots onto Intet. Give it a haste. It's now a 9/9. And right,
in response to the Swiftfoot Boots, I'm going to tap it.
My dragon?
Your dragon.
Okay, well, they're still gone. And he gets to hang out and be cute and fast and hasty and tapped.
I am fine with tapping.
I wasn't going to swing at you, but fine.
I passed
my turn and sat again.
All right, let's see what we can do here.
Chat, I'm just saying, non-basic land, I'm here for.
I'm going to play a Mosswort Bridge. Let's see what's up under here.
Hide away.
We'll put that under there. And then... I have this whole pile of mana. What to do? Let's go with 1, 3. Five. I'm gonna play Archon of Justice. 4-point flyer, and when it leaves play, it gets to exile a thing.
Nice.
Is it exile permanent or exile creature?
Exile a permanent.
Gross.
We gotta have some defensive cards.
Gross.
And then I'm gonna go ahead get. Already played a land for the turn, so I guess I will take a damage to get some green mana, so I can go ahead and use this Mosswort Bridge.
Give me just one quick second. Because we have the poll results. So I'm going to put an effect on the stack now. And that effect says, each player searches their library for a non-basic land and puts it onto the battlefield, then discards a card from their hand.
A non-basic?
Non-basic.
It's the thing says non-basic land. So apparently, yes.
Oh, boy.
Thanks, Chad.
Thank you very much,
Chad. What non-basic land do we want?
I will go and get my Gaia's Cradle. Oh wait, I don't have a Gaia's Cradle.
Chad is asking if that Mosswort Bridge came into the play this turn, because if so, it might be tapped.
Oh, well, correct that then. I will save the life and put this back. It does indeed enter tapped.
We do not know what's under the bridge at all.
It does indeed come in tapped.
It's not correct. One of my favorite cards of all time.
dang it. What land do I get here?
I'm making a strong cradle impression with the coffers.
Okay. I guess I will go get a cradle, but it's not going to do a whole lot here. I'm kind of flooded on mana as it is, but maybe one day I will need it.
I guess I'll discard a Bajuka Bog because I don't really feel like I need to worry about any of your graveyards.
Yeah. What gives you that impression?
That I'm the only black mage at this table.
Yeah. Well, I'm also a black mage, so it works out.
I get a tectonic edge. Not relevant.
That's fine.
All right. Let's
figure out what to do. Ancestry.
I will discard a Firelit Thicket. Because, you know, all the manas.
Yeah, we know.
And then from here, what to do? All right. Let's go after... Hey, chat, who should I attack?
Don't get chat involved in this.
Gavin, did you get your discard?
I'm working on it.
Okay.
All right. Let's go after... I have a feeling I'm going to die to all of you. This is what's crazy.
Get me.
Attack them first.
All right. Let's go after Lee.
That's not attacking them first.
With Tangar. Why not? We will do that.
All right. I'm going to go to blocks. Or are we going... Gavin, are you going to mess with my blockers?
Yeah, I'll tap your... I'm going to make... a token, and then I will tap Rhys and the token to tap the two of the thralls.
Two of the thralls?
Yeah.
Okay.
Gavin, what did you do? The chat's mad at you. They're trying to get me to attack you for not having your commander in play? Or not having a commander?
I have a commander. It is in
play. It's just not exactly. Set.
He hasn't set his commander in. I'm going to throw a sad robot in front of Tongarth.
Seems good.
It might have been for not playing it on turn one, which is an acceptable reason.
Fair. And then I'm going to go ahead and get an absurd amount of mana from my guy's cradle. Actually, it's really not. One, two, three. And actually, let's go ahead and get Rith into play. So now I have a dragon. Brand identity complete.
The dragon is here.
Is that the original Rith or the new Rith?
No, this is one from one of the... I think it's from one of the special sets. Little whatever we call used to call the box sets that come with all the foil cards.
FTV yes. Dominaria?
Yeah, from the vaults. There you go.
All right. So we're all done?
Yep, it's on Gavin.
Okay. One, two, three, Sacred Mesa. Play a Selesnya Sanctuary, picking up a land. I'm going to frown heavily about my choice of mana tapping. I will make a Pegasus. One Pegasus. And I will take one for the team, pointing this out. All right, tech... Edge. That guy's cradle is always bad, but in this case, I'm going after the Cabal Coffers.
Reasonable.
DeQuan, I took this one for you.
I appreciate it. One day I will have a lot of cards, and my guy's cradle will be awesome, and I will really, really appreciate it.
All right, I will pass the turn and flip the rights.
Okay. Do you have exactly four creatures?
I have exactly four creatures. Am I going to have four creatures when it resolves?
No, I'm going to cast down the Pegasus.
All right.
And then I will cycle a Baron Moor. And greed is good.
Yeah, if I tapped properly, I could have had five, but I screwed it up.
Look, you blow up my stupid mana land, I'll blow up your stupid mana. Stop your stupid mana land from existing.
All right.
For a turn. Okay. I like this card a lot. I'm going to pitch three thralls on the altar, have six colorless so that I don't have to blow up my favorite boy. I'm going to play a Phyrexian Plague Lord.
Nice.
Five thralls.
The Rock and his millions. For those who don't know, for a long time, black-green decks were referred to as rock decks. The Rock was originally named after Phyrexian Plague Lord and Hermit Druid, who basically were the heart of a deck that fed each other, and named after a certain over-the-top media character.
I feel like Endrek does a good fill-in for the Hermit Druid. All right, so I've got three colorless left floating from the altar. I'm going to use it and two more black to play a Black Market.
Oh, dear. Folks...
Just all the wild, crazy cards over here.
We need to kill him real quick.
Agreed.
I'm going to say, after that... All right, so I've got a bit of mana. So I'm going to need to use two of those for that. I'm going to sack... four thralls to the Plague Lord to give a -1/-1 to Rhys. And you have how many? You have two elf tokens right now?
Two elf tokens right now. In response, I will tap Plague Lord, and then he dies.
Yep. And then I'm going to sack... two more tokens to kill your two elf tokens.
Sure. I will issue the single customary polite response of reminding you of your black market triggers, and yes. I will tap your Rager and your... Do you have any thralls in play at the moment?
I have three more that I'm about to throw into an Ashnod's Altar.
All right. I'll tap the 1/1.
Okay. Pitch the other three to Ashnod's Altar. All right, so that's six colorless. Use three of it. Two black to play a Sidisi. Get five thralls.
Oh, when she enters,
I'll sack one to her exploit. That leaves me with three. So only other thing I will do... is I will then use the rest of the colorless and a black to cast the Pitiless Plunderer I get, and I'll feed enough thralls to alter and just let the mana go away that Endrek sticks around, and then I will pass to Ailey.
Hey, Eric, we need a donation target. Mana burn comes into effect.
You know, I would even accept it. Ouch.
I like this a lot. I'll talk to the producers, see what we can come up with.
Okay, so that it would make four, so I'd need to just randomly feed two extras.
You done with all your things there?
Oh, yeah. No, I'm totally done. Please, continue.
All right, Ailey, relying on you to help deal with the Thrall Menace.
All right.
I'm so sorry. I've made terrible choices.
One, two, three.
Look. You all chose these bright, happy, fun colors. We needed a bad guy. I'm happy to be the bad guy.
Every story needs a
villain. You know what? I respect that.
7. I'm going to cast Ataka, World Render. Whenever Dragon you control attacks, it gains double strike until end of turn. I'm going to give it some booties. Any response? Nope. Am I allowed to do this?
Yeah, everyone that's fine. Yeah, cool. I made a horrible mistake in tapping it last time. I'm certainly not going to make the same mistake twice.
It has haste, it's hexproof, it wants to smack Lee very hard, and we are going to combat.
Yeah.
And both at Lee, both with double strike, both at 9.
Both 9 power with double strike?
Yeah.
You know, I think that actually means I'm a very dead boy.
Woohoo!
Look, I'm supposed to be a villain. I'm
sending the game to Ashnod's altar.
In response,
yeah, exactly. You need great patch. The problem is you've only got 5 broken enchantments. You need 6.
Okay.
Grave Pact is not in here intentionally.
Okay.
All right. You and I have a heart.
People can revive you, though. So just if you want to bring back the mono black player chat, just saying.
That's true. They can.
Okay. So I'm not going to do the trigger on there. I did have a scry trigger off the opulence. No, sorry. The Path of Ancestry. So let me do that quick.
Does chat have the ability to pool donations, or does it have to be like one person donates $200? Because I feel like it would be cool if they could all sort of throw $5 towards something and team up.
I would happily
encourage people to bring back.
Hey, it's more money for a good cause. So, friends, if you'd like to undo what I just did and bring Lee back, you know what to do. What else can I do?
Give them like 2 minutes, and if it goes up at least $200, they could revive Lee.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
I'll pass my turn.
All right.
So,
get to untap all these things.
All right, and so the revival brings me back, resetting my board, so I still should pick up and shuffle, I think.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's nifty.
We're getting some way of letting you back into the game.
Before we think about that, I do have a $15 donation from Anonymous for DeQuan to scry 1. So go ahead and scry.
Fantastic. I will. Oh, that's a good one. That can stay. all right. Let's start with...
So it's $15. DeQuan gets to spend the next 2 minutes enjoying like what's coming.
Exactly. We'll get 2 green. 1, 2... Finally, for real, get the Lurking Predators into play.
Yeah.
And 3, 4. We're going to play Sarkin's Unsealing.
Ooh, nice.
People hadn't seen that yet. There you go.
Well, if you hold it still, we can click on it.
Yeah, sure. It's every time I play a creature with a power 4, 5, or 6, it deals 4 to a target. If I play one with power 7 or greater, it deals 4 to all opponents and all their things.
Hello, board wipe.
Pew, pew.
Actually, it does say each opponent. Never mind. And then, though the black player is gone now, oh, I'm not going to have enough to do that. Never mind. I cannot do what I want to do. I was just kidding. That's not a thing.
JK.
all right. We will send... Oh, my God. Ailey, your dragons are so huge.
Yep. Be afraid. Be very afraid.
I am, actually. let's send Rith over to you and... Tangarth at Gavin, I think is what we'll do.
5?
Rith is 7/7, Tangarth is 6/6.
I'm taking 6. I would just like to point out, perhaps you two should team up and kill me. Because it gets worse from here.
Yeah.
Fair.
I won't hold it against you. But I killed the one problem at the table. You guys have to deal with the next one.
Exactly.
This is true.
Other than that, I think that's going to be it for me.
All right. Untap. Make a Pegasus, sack the Pegasus.
Or Pegasus.
Yeah. It was briefly a Pegasus.
Oh, wait, actually. Dang it. I should have triggered Rith. I had mana.
Yes, yes you should. So you have many tokens?
Yeah, what was it? 1, 2, 3. I choose, I guess, green, because you also have green permanents.
Don't you have, yeah, like a million mana with Mirari's Wake anyway?
Yeah, I have tons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Your isn't in play. So 7 is what we get there.
Oh, okay.
So which dragon is wearing the boots at the moment?
Atarka.
Yeah, Atarka.
Tarka.
And Tet is just hanging out.
All right. I'm going to play Austere Command for big creatures and artifacts.
What does that do?
Actually, does anybody have any small creatures?
No. I have a bunch of tutus.
Yeah, all right. So, Austere Command for... Oh, I really want to get rid of that Sarkhan's enchantment, but it just decimates my board. Austere Command is choose two, destroy artifacts, enchantments, big creatures, or small creatures.
Okay.
Well, expensive cheap creatures are cheap creatures, technically. Great. So definitely creatures with converted mana cost 4 or greater are being destroyed.
Okay.
Fair.
How many tutus do you have?
I have 7. Guys here, they're getting a +1/+1 from the Mari's Wake.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, we have a trigger, actually, from you casting a spell. Is not a creature because I knew it was on top of my deck. Oh, I have to reveal it anyway, though, actually. I either get to leave it there or put it on top. It's a Kessig Wolf Run.
Oh, okay. Relevant.
Yeah.
All right. Big creatures and small creatures. So,
okay.
I will cast a Bad Wrath of God for 6.
We will exile. I feel like I should say growing rights, but dang, Ailey's got some tasty stuff over there.
Yeah, I don't have any creatures growing. Growing,
yeah, exactly. Let's get rid of... man, giving all your dragons a giant boost is awful, too.
Oh, it's totally
probably
fine.
Probably Swiftfoot Boots, so we at least have a chance to kill something and not die to it.
You killing this?
Yeah, we'll exile the Swiftfoot Boots.
Ow. Okay. I accept the charges.
I wonder how many people still know what that expression means. Pass the turn.
All right.
That's me.
Yep.
Untap all the things and stuff. Guard. Land for turn. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. What do we want to do? I think it's Morphon time. Let's get the big boy out.
Here he comes.
2.
Choose are legally distinct.
Crab
song here.
5, 6, 7. I will not choose crab. I will choose dragon. If it happens to be a crab dragon, then cool. But I doubt it. Trigger here.
I think they call those Leviathans or something.
My buddy
Wooburg less to cast, which is pretty neat. Fortunately, I don't have any Wooburg dragons in hand at the moment. What I think I'll do is take off one counter, draw a card.
Seems fair.
And you don't have haste or anything. You're just a good old 9/9 right now. 9/9! And I can do nothing, so
only
you make
a 9/9.
Only a 9/9.
I can appreciate that, though. I'm a big fan of the big creatures. All right. Well, we'll draw that Kessig Wolf Run that's been sitting there forever. And 2, 4, 5. Actually, let me go ahead and use this. And we'll display Sigarda, Host of Herons. 5/5, flying, hexproof. And spells and abilities opponents control can't make me sacrifice things. And, oh, I get to deal 4. It's still 4 to Ailey, because I have a feeling these dragons are going to get out of hand.
4?
Yep, from the Sarkin's Unsealing. And I think that is all for me. So, yeah, just pass.
All right. End of the turn, I will pay 1 life to make a Pegasus. And I will tap Morphon. Because it's an artifact creature, it doesn't. All of its static abilities stop working when it's tapped, right? No?
What's that? Oh, gotcha. I see where you're getting at.
If only.
All right. Untap, roll for Mana Crypt. On odds, I'll take damage. 8 is a strange number, but it is not an odd number. Draw for the turn. Oh, sacrifice said Pegasus. One, 2, 3, replay Rhys for 3.
Ooh, we get a Gisela.
5, 6.
I am going to deal 4 to Ailey.
All right.
We get. Where did the Gisela come from?
From the Lurking Predators.
Lurking Predators.
Well, my then.
I don't think you won't do the 4 to Ailey, though.
Oh, no, it's only true. Correct. It's when I cast, not when they come into play. Gain 4 life, Ailey.
Okay.
All right. I will make some Pegasus and pass the turn. Attempt to trigger rights again.
I'm not here to stop you this time.
Excellent. Pass the turn.
Is it me?
Yep, it's you. And you can untap your Morphon.
I have exciting news that at least one of you is already aware of. The Free Endrek campaign has been resolved, and Lee has been revived.
Nice.
What could possibly go wrong?
Good job, donors.
You all are beautiful. All right, so I get basics equal to the lowest number of lands everyone has.
I feel like the person who should get credit for that knows they should get credit for that because they're awesome.
Backs.
I have 8 lands.
I have 9.
I have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
All right, so 8 lands.
That's a good number.
That is. That's.
I think, and mechanically, as I understand it, Lee, you will return to the game once your turn would start. So you can't just attack Lee to death before he gets another turn. Just in case any of you were thinking about it.
You can't farm me for donations.
It's okay. It just gives my dragon something else to munch on. I did not draw a land. Oh, I did not draw a land. I don't know what I drew. Okay, there we go. Right. So, yeah, it's my turn, right? Okay. I'm going to play Haven of the Spirit Dragon.
Haven of the Spirit Dragon.
I get to bring...
criminally underused land.
Yeah, it's really good. Okay, who's on watch? What have you got, Gavin?
On the board?
Yeah. What's your like toughness is? You got a bunch of ones, right?
1-1-1-1.
1-1-1-1. Cool. All right. So what we're gonna do then is go.
Looks like one of us making... brought knives to a gunfight.
This is making all my dragons Wooburg cheap to cost. So we're gonna go for. It actually doesn't matter because now it's all colors. 1, 2, 3, 4. We. Siligmar, the Drifting Death. It's flying hexproof, and whenever a dragon you control attacks, creatures defending player control get -1/-1 till end of turn.
Trigger lurking predators.
That's the first thing I'm doing.
We get in a rally.
It may have effects in your pre-combat.
Okay. Just shout when. 2 mana. I'm going to cast Wasitora, Nekoru Queen. Flying and trample. When this deals combat damage to a player, that player sacrifices a creature. If they can't, I create a 3/3 black, red, and green cat dragon creature token with flying. If you kill this, I will find you, and I will pull out your internet.
Do not kill trigger my cat. Lurking predators. Oh, for Garrick's Harbinger.
Then one more for the funsies, because I can. Let's use all our mana. Whee! 5. I've got a bunch of thingies there too, I'll do. Tyrant's Familiar. Flying in haste. As long as you control your commander, Tyrant's Familiar gets +2/+2 and has whenever this attacks, it deals 7 damage to target creature defending player controls. Yay.
Right. Trigger lurking predators.
So 1, 2, 3.
This has been sick hits. Archangel Flume.
Sweet.
I mean, that is the best lurking predators I've ever seen, and that's a really high bar.
Yeah, no joke. Like, I always hit like 3 lands and then like 1 creature.
You're welcome.
Hey, players with access to like green or white, you wanna deal with like enchantments maybe? That's
I have ways, but we're busy putting creatures in play.
Yes, we're having fun. Okay. Gavin, I'm coming for you.
Well, if you're coming for me, then I will have to tap the 2 2 hasty ones.
No. Okay. Right, fine. DeQuan, get him.
All right. What can we do here?
This is the old, my shields are down, so I'm clearly not attacking you, Gambit. I don't think he's going to fall for it.
I just got to figure out how much damage we can do. This is a ton. Actually, I guess, Gavin, how many creatures do you have the ability to tap here?
2.
Okay. That is relevant. Man, this is scary. It's like, we can do a lot of damage, but I could also just die to dragons.
I mean, they're not going after you. They're going after the player with the small things.
Let's see. What can we do?
Tell you what. Right. I will. I'm gonna tap the cat dragon.
Oh. Okay.
No touchy kitty cat.
The other one is hexproof, so unfortunately.
No, I understand. I appreciate.
DeQuan, right, avenge me.
Let's send. I mean, I do have to be concerned that Lee is getting back in the game with a whole pile of mana.
I will do nothing to harm you in any way on my first 2 turns. If you swing everything at Ailey.
Hang on one second. I'm just trying to remember. Or really, the war leader is the...
Gets to make a second attack.
Yeah, it's the relentless assault angel.
Yeah.
All right, I'm just going to preemptively tap the relentless assault angel.
Makes sense. Totally reasonable. Okay.
Gavin's just like, everything's a threat.
Oh, and Gisella's bad, too.
Yeah.
No, Gisella's real bad, but tapping her doesn't do nearly as much.
No, I totally get it. I'm just reminding the table that it exists.
Oh, yes. No, we are all very much in the could-be-dead-shortly zone.
Goodness. All right, let's send Archangel Thune at... Gavin, do you have any flyers currently?
I do not.
Okay. We're going to send this your way.
I tapped all my creatures to give you the ability to block Ely.
And we will send...
The rest of Ely. You can do it. I believe in you.
Encouraging bad habits, but I appreciate it.
I remind you of the statement, you should probably kill me shortly, made by...
Also true. Okay, so we're going to send Gisella, Garrix Harbinger, and Sigarda at Ailey. We're going to send the Archangel of Thune at Gavin.
Okay.
So how much is flying at me? And doesn't it get double strike with Gisella?
Yeah, so it's... Well, double damage. So it's 6... 12, that's another 5, so 22.
Ugh.
6, 12, 17, 32.
Oh, true, it is.
34. Yeah. I can math.
Yeah, so much.
It just deals double damage, right?
Yeah.
How big is your flyers?
They're each 6/6. Gisella does have first strike, though.
H66s. Okay, so I'll block the Harbinger's coming at me, right?
Yes.
Okay, I'll block the Harbinger with the 6/10.
Seems good.
Siligmar.
So I took 8?
I'm actually deciding what we're going to pump with the Castle Wolf run here.
Yep.
Do it.
Don't kill me, DeQuan. I gave you all these creatures.
You did give me quite a few creatures. I'm highly appreciative.
Yeah, so don't kill me.
All right, that's fair. You did give me all the creatures, so I will not kill you. I'm going to pump a bunch of mana into this Kessig Wolf run that's going at Gavin, so I'll at least gain a bunch of life in case Ailey backstabs me here.
Yeah, there you go. How much do I take from your other creature?
You take, let's see, 12, 22, 24.
Oof.
And then I'm going to pump 2, 4.
Ow.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10,
11, 12, 13, 14, 15. That's way more than lethal.
Minus 2, so it's 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Onto the Archangel of Thune for 21 to make that 42.
42 is enough.
All right.
Holy
so
crap.
I gain a whole pile of life, and then I'll put some counters on all my things.
Good lord.
Yeah. Well, that happened. Yeah, I'm just coming back to a smoldering crater. It's fine.
Yeah. I think your Garrick's Harbinger dies.
It does. It is thoroughly squashed.
Okay, cool. My guy gets to live.
I will pass the turn.
All right, Lee.
All right, well.
I laugh, he draws a board wipe.
Probably will at this point.
I very dearly wish. Oh, no. Well, the best I got is...
Play a 1/1. Do it.
Well, first I'm going to play a 2/2.
Sure.
So yeah, really, really kicking it up here.
Trigger the predators with Defense of the Heart, which is going to the bottom.
DeQuan can just Shrek me on this next turn.
You're both very, very dead on his next turn.
Actually, yeah, I can. I'm not gonna play Endrek. I have to
78. Oof.
I have to put some amount of ability to stop things into play. All right, first thing I'm gonna do. I'm gonna play a Blood Artist. So even better, I played a 0/1.
Yeah.
I'm gonna play a Noxious Gear Hulk and eat Gisela.
Ooh, nice.
Gain 7 life.
We will also trigger the Lurking Predators for Wooded Foothills that's going to go to the bottom.
And then... So I will drain... I'll drain, drain DeQuan for 1 with the Blood Artist.
Did you just say I'll drain Gavin?
That's what I'll drain. Yeah, I'll drain from the dead one. I'll drain DeQuan for 1. Gotta like chip away at the 77 life.
Totally understandable. You gotta start somewhere.
Yeah.
What's the saying? How do you eat an elephant? 1 bite at a time.
Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That is a whole lot of elephant. So I'm going to pass the turn and let Ailey.
I got this.
I believe in you. I believe in your powers.
Good.
Hey, her dragons are huge right now, honestly.
They are massive.
They are ginormous. Okay.
That's scary.
Right.
I'm concerned.
We are going to... DeQuan, are you tapped out?
I am.
Sweet. We are going to sacrifice...
I'm dying dragons here, but...
Even of the spirit dragon to return target dragon card from the graveyard to my hand. I'm here, big boy. Who's a good dragon? Who's a good dragon? You are.
The biggest dragon, mama.
The biggest dragon. 1.
Sad but 2, true.
3. 4. 5. Arr. Okay. And we have a bunch of dragons. We have a trigger here. Boop. Let's just draw just to see what we get here. A counter. Okay. All right. Now let's do some quick math. You have no blockers. You're completely tapped out. All my dudes are ginormous. Right.
We cast a spell, correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Lurking Predator says
no,
we
wait.
Nothing.
Did we? No, we didn't.
Did you?
Okay. I just sacrificed. Oh, wait. No, I did it. I cost it. Yeah. Okay. Ataka.
Well, either way, this is going to the bottom. It's a Sylvan Awakening.
Yay. Oh, okay, cool. All right. So you can't attack. You can attack. Let's do some quick math here. All right. So you're on 77. Okay. So you are 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. Enough. Old double strike. Oh, she also buffs everyone.
Seems good. Morphon.
So 33, 34, 35, 36. That's 72.
Does the familiar when it attacks and you have your commander burn any target or only a creature?
It deals 7 damage to target creature defending player controls.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's go to combat anyway, because this is my last 2 raw, because I'm pretty sure DeQuan's going to kill me next turn. Okay.
So, how bad is it?
Let's see. Okay, so I have my commander. We've got +3 across the board, +1 to all my other dragons. He's got +2 as well. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11.
So you've got 11, 11.
12, 13, 14, 15, 17, 18, 19, 20, 23, 7, 8, 9, 30, 31, 33, 4, 35, 36. Double strike damage. And then a few effects during combat. That's a lot.
What is that, like 74?
It's not enough, but it's a lot. I'm helping you out here, Lee.
If you, I might even be able to do a bit because of Blood Artist.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, true.
Sure. Yeah. Sure. So, okay, so there's triggers here as well. So whenever this attacks, it deals 7 damage to target creature it defending player controls. What's your biggest thing that I can smack down there?
The biggest thing is Sigarda, but you probably want to kill Aurelia because it gives me 2 attack steps.
Sigarda has Hexproof too, right?
Oh, that's true. Yeah,
so I'll smack whatever I can that's the biggest thing on your battlefield. Because I also get -1/-1 triggers off of Siligmar. I get 4 of those.
Nice.
So okay. They all...
So smack the biggest thing. Whenever a dragon you control attacks creatures, defending player get -1/-1. So there's -4/-4 across your board.
Okay. So I have currently a 0/1 and a 2/2.
Cool. And then if there's no blockers, which I'm guessing there aren't, whenever Wastasaur deals combat damage to a player, that player sacrifices a creature. So with the first strike, you'll sacrifice a creature.
Well, Sigarda keeps me from sacrificing, so I don't have to worry about that.
Oh, true. Okay. It says, if you can't, then I get a 3/3 cat dragon token. So if you can't sacrifice,
you
does
do
that
indeed.
Work? I get a kitty? Yay!
Yeah, I think that does.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Kitty! So I get 2 kitties. Meow. Hang on, where's the other one? Okay, we'll just do. So I get 2 kitties with the attack. And then I think that's all my effects. Yes, and then you just take a bunch of damage.
11,
20. So was that 36 times 2?
72.
You're on all 5. Right.
And then I'll also drain you for 1 DeQuan with the Blood Artist death trigger on your...
Seems good. So I go all the way down to 4.
Whew. Drat. Couldn't kill you.
You know what 4 isn't? 0.
It's not 0.
Yeah. I tried my best. I have no other burn things.
That was a pretty savage hit, though. Gotta be honest.
Nothing else I can do, unfortunately. So I'm guessing Daquan's gonna kill me now. Considering I'm at 3.
Daquan's gonna kill both of you and like twice over.
Yeah,
that would be the plan.
Oh, maybe.
Some exciting news about that. We are now entering CommandFest overtime, where some things do change in the game as time moves on. And we've got a couple of effects that have come in starting this turn. First of all, we've got Howling Mine. Everybody's going to draw an extra card in their draw step. And then we've got sort of an exciting one where creatures are going to get a little more powerful. Specifically, they are going to get haste and double strike. So,
Well, the game just ends now then, doesn't it?
Well, that's news. Okay.
Haste and double strike.
Well, the bad news for me is that extra card didn't help at all. So,
well beyond relevant.
I am going to... I guess Ailey's without flyers now, huh?
I have 2 cat dragons.
Oh, they do. Cat dragons do fly. Look at that.
Yeah. And they have double strike.
They do.
No, only when it attacks.
Oh, when they attack. Okay.
Yeah. I thought all the creatures overtime thing is all creatures have double strike right now.
Yes, you're right. Yeah. You're right.
Yes.
Oh.
Got double strike. So that's attackers and blockers. Have fun with that.
Yeah, I'm just realizing that. That's all creatures all the time. Okay. Well, we will play a land because that will be relevant here. And attack the Archangel into... Ailey and Sigarda into Lee. And I'll just pump everything into the Archangel.
Does it get trample or anything?
It does get trample.
Yeah.
Oh, well then I'm super dead.
Yeah. You can't say Wolf Run was the bane of most of
the... So it'd be 17 plus 4 is 21 twice.
Well, you can take the Archangel down with it, though, with the double-striking cats. Huh?
I mean, yeah, I can kill whatever I can try.
As it turns out, you're only going to gain half the life, though.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true.
Either whether so you block with the cats or not.
Okay, well, yeah, I'll double block the thing killing me to kill it.
Makes sense.
With my double striking cats.
Meow! Right. Okay. Three things then, die, so you'll also get drained for three.
Yeah. So this gets a counter. I gain 21, go to 25, minus 3, end up at 22.
End up at 22, and then you hit me with Sigarda for 5 or 6.
Yeah. Or actually, it was 7 because of the. Wait.
Or she got the second counter from the Archangel after damage.
Yeah, wait. She was 6 already, plus 1.
Oh, yeah, Mirari. Just so. Yep.
And then that is it.
Gross. Yeah, smoking craters. And a cat. A very happy cat.
Yeah. You've got a bit of a 20
double strike. You could potentially still kill me here.
It's true.
Did you not get any life there, DeQuan?
I did. I went to 22. I was at 4 previously.
Okay. Just up it on the spell table.
And then creature.
Oh, I guess it didn't.
Creatures get haste, right?
Yep. That's what I'm saying. I could still die here.
Haste and double strike.
All right, so I'm going to play Endrek Sahr.
All right, here's hoping on this Lurking Predators. Harder than I've ever hoped. Nope, it's just a stomping ground.
Yeah. I'm going to cast a Cavalier of Night.
Oh, no.
Nice.
So get 5 1-1s.
Oh, here's a good hit, though. Karmic Guide.
Gross. That's bad. I don't like this anymore.
All
right, so this is on the cast. Correct?
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, what do you get?
That's what I'm double checking. Like, what do I want to get here that matters? Let's get Archon of Justice.
It's fair. Okay, so Cavalier will resolve. When it enters, I'll sack the Blood Artist to destroy your Archon.
Seems fair.
Oh, I draw an extra card from the Howling Moon. Doesn't change what I did, but that is relevant.
Then we will...
And you'll also be drained for one.
True. Man, I don't know if I want to get rid of Endrek or just save myself a pile of damage here. I think we'll just get rid of Endrek. That seems smart.
Okay. And you have a Karmic Guide as your only blocker?
Correct.
Okay. Going to go to combat. The Blood Artist died for your thing. I'm going to attack you with a Noxious Gear Hulk that has Menace, 5 1-1s, and a 4-5 with Lifelink.
Well, that might... let's see. We can block the 4-5, I guess. It'd be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 20.
I'm going to put you at 1.
Yeah. Okay, I think that's what I've got to do.
All right.
Oh, I have protection for black. Random words that don't ever matter on Karmic Guide.
I know, right? I love that person. and then I'm done.
Okay.
Yes you are.
Stop it. Gavin, stop it. Just because I'm very dead. With him at 1.
You're doing an excellent impression of Jim, the main character from 28 Days Later, where you wake up and the world is just destroyed around you, except for one really bad thing going on over there.
Just the John Travolta meme, just running around like, where is everyone?
Yeah, we'll just have to let this die. I can't spend the mana. I have to spend everything else to try to win here. Oh, that card is way too late. All right. I guess with nothing in the way, we are going to... Turbo load Sigarda for a whole lot of damage.
Give me a count.
2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, minus 2, so 18 plus whatever that is, 8. So 26 doubled up.
I believe that goes from free Endrek to rip Endrek. I am now very dead.
Nice. Good time. Nice.
That was good.
Score 1 for the Rift Dragon.
DeQuan. All right.
And the cats get a win. That's more important.
Yeah. Yay, cats.
I think what I appreciate about that type of game is, like, everybody's deck did their things.
Exactly. I got to see all sorts of big stuff. That was a blast. Thank you all for the game.
Yeah, that was definitely fun. Cat Cam!
My cats approve of the victory for cats.
They are so chill and happy.
That was a fantastic game. That was a great game. Thanks, everybody.
Hey, thanks for having me. This was a blast.
Good job, chat. Yes. Keep the donos going.
Thank you so much.
All right. It sounds like we're going to go to a break. So thanks, everybody, for continuing to watch CommandFest Online 2. We'll be back very soon.